Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This video has been requested on my Snapchat a lot. I do talk a lot about how I did have a lot of acne back when I moved from California over to Nebraska, which it's a new state. I moved 2 years ago, and because of the weather change, I started breaking out really bad. And I always tell girls on my Snapchat how skincare is very important to me, because obviously, you know, I got rid of it and I don't want to go back to that stage. So of course this video is dedicated to everyone who's interested in my skincare and want to try out different things. Basically, persons who have acne or just wanting to take care of the skin on a daily basis. If you wear makeup or not, you have to basically know that you always have to take care of your skin. You know, no matter if you wear so much cake, if you don't, you're just natural. You always have to have a routine of yours just to maintain your skin as healthy as possible, because of course it's also an organ. The way your heart is, the way your liver, your lungs, can you take care of those? You also want to take care of your skin. So let's go ahead and start this YouTube video. I'm going to go ahead and start my night routine, which obviously I'm not going to take off my makeup or anything like that, but I'm going to show you what I use every single night after I remove my makeup. Obviously not every day I wear heavy makeup. I do go on the light side, sometimes very natural, because of course I have to work on a daily basis and I don't have, you know, all that time or want to wake up early just to make sure I look glammed up. So I'm going to start off with my favorite makeup remover wipes. I always make sure that I use eye makeup remover separately and makeup remover wipes. So my favorites are the Neoutregena ones. Of course, these are my favorite. These are the number ones that everyone uses. Not everyone uses, but I'm saying, like, me personally, these are my favorite. I tried a lot of different ones and I feel like these ones just fit my skin so perfectly when removing my makeup. And of course, you don't want to tug your eye with the makeup remover, because that's gonna go ahead and just basically create wrinkles throughout time. And of course, if you have anything waterproof, it's not gonna help, and it's just gonna rub your eye as much and basically just hurt it. So of course, I do use the Neutrogena eye makeup remover. This is sad, because look how much I have, like, literally down to nothing. I need to buy a new one. So my routine with this makeup remover wipes is, what I do is I first remove my eye makeup with a cotton ball. Once I do remove that eye makeup, of course I do throw away that cotton ball. I try to clean any black dust around it just to make sure that it doesn't go too much on my skin. Then that's when these come in. What is so special the way I use this is because, of course, take one out of the package, remove all my face makeup, make sure I get everything I want. Makeup removers can only do so much. I'm telling you, they do not remove all your makeup. That is why I'm gonna go ahead and show you exactly what I do after. But when I do remove my makeup with the makeup remover wipes, I also like to rinse it. So I rinse it with really warm water to open up my pores. I clean it as much as I can. I rinse it just to make sure all the foundation, anything, washes out. Of course, it's still gonna be a little bit dirty, but once I rinse that makeup remover wipe, I like to go in with my Garnier micellar cleansing water. This helps if there's any foundation still on my face get removed. I love to do this step. I don't feel like it's an extra step. I feel like it's an extra step to cleaning my skin, just to making sure that when I do go in with the face wash, you know, I'm gonna be removing as less as I can. Of course, like I said, a makeup remover only does so much. So I go in after with the micellar water, but I do rinse the makeup remover wipe, because of course, I don't wanna just add it to what's already built up of makeup of dirty bacteria on it, because it's not gonna work like that. So definitely this one is by Garnier. It's really affordable. I used to use the Biodermal one. I think that's the name of it, I can't remember. But I don't know, I really like how this one, even the pink bottle one or this blue one, they work fantastic. I mean, it's just micellar cleansing water. It's basically a water that has like oils in it. Just removes every part. It breaks down every particle of makeup, if I'm being like very descriptive. But yeah, that's what I like to do. So I remove my makeup first with the makeup remover wipe, if of course I've already removed my eye makeup. And then I rinse it, then I go in with the micellar water. Once I'm done with that, of course, I am going to be going in with my favorite face wash. When I was breaking out really, really bad and I didn't know what to do, like I'm telling you, I used to cry because my skin was terrible. And of course, good makeup comes from good skin. But my problem was that I had really bad acne. When I would put on makeup, it would just be so sad, because I would look and I'd be like, damn, like I wish my skin was flawless, how everyone's skin is. You know, just smooth, a smooth canvas. And I tried every full coverage foundation, every primer I can think of, but my face would just not look good. It would not look how I wanted, and I just got tired of it. I wanted to see a dermatologist, but dermatologists are so expensive that I kind of wanted to get out of that zone of just going straight to a dermatologist, just because, you know what, I need to start giving more products a try. I need to start finding a different way just to take care of my skin. And I decided one day, instead of going to Sephora and buying makeup, you know what, I'm just gonna buy skincare. So I did buy the Murad 30-day kit. And the 30-day kit, it brings a few small items which you can use for 30 days. And only out of all of them, my favorite one since then has been this one. This Murad Clarifying Acne Cleanser. This has been my favorite ever since I got rid of acne. Just because I started noticing, you know, how much cleanser my skin would feel. The next day I saw that in my pillowcase, I wouldn't see, you know, like extra makeup, which I know it's disgusting to say and think about it now. Like, I wouldn't sleep on a dirty pillowcase, but before I just wasn't thinking about it. And then also moving from one state to another caused my acne just to be severe. And applying makeup and not removing it right or having the right skin routine was just affecting it even more. So like I said, I went to Sephora, I got the 30-day kit, and I decided to use everything in there. But this one has become my favorite. It does say that it helps treat existing acne and prevents future breakouts. Delivers time-release acne medication that remains active for hours even after rinsing. And then it also does say here that it, oh, let's see what it ingredients. Give me 1 second. There you go. It has encapsulated salicylic acid, but the salicylic acid is not too strong to the point where like it dries your face out and it starts flaking it. I tried products with salicylic acid and I'm telling you, they were irritating my skin so bad just because I'm so sensitive. But the salicylic acid on this product is very sensitive to your skin. Like, I'm telling you, it didn't affect me with being a sensitive skin person. Like I said, it releases acne treatment for hours even after rinsing. Silver citrate helps purify skin surface, promoting a clarified complexion. Black cohosh and green tea extract helps with acne stressed skin. So even with stressing about my acne and just, you know, not having the right skincare routine or things like that, we're all causing my acne just to be, you know, to elongate, basically not even get better. So I started using this one and I started seeing, you know, I started seeing the difference between how my skin was looking, but I was still getting breakouts. Then it came down to someone gifted me a spin brush, and of course it's not the, you know, the very expensive one. This one is by Mary Kay and it's only like $50. Like, it's not expensive. It does come with like two removable you know, head brushes here. This also was a big thing in my skincare routine, because I started noticing that when I was washing my face with my hands, I know I wasn't removing everything off. And when I started using this, even after I cleaned everything, the makeup remover wise, the micellar water, the eye makeup remover, I still had, you know, all the stuff on my face that wasn't removed properly. So basically this spin brush, it just spins like this. And what once you start using it all over your face, it's going to be removing all the deep things that are deep in your skin. I don't know how to say it, but it's like a deep cleansing. Basically doing your own facial at home, not like a specific facial where it removes, you know, blackheads. But this definitely, with my Murad Acne Cleanser Wash, does make a difference of basically making sure that I have everything removed. I use this on a daily basis. A lot of people don't like to use a spin brush because it's harsh on their skin. This spin brush here, this head right here, is super soft. Like, it's super, super soft. It's not like one of those stiff ones that hurts your skin and basically, you know, starts causing it to get irritated. This one's just like regular. It's super soft, and then it has different levels that you can use. Like right here, it's like at fast. My battery might be dying, but it can go faster. And then you can make it go slow. So it has like different levels. Here you see it go fast and then slow right there. And then it has like the power off button. And then it does come with two removable heads that you have to replace so often, which is not an issue, of course. You can keep them a little bit longer than the indicated time, but it's always preferably to remove them and get new ones. How the instructions are instructed. They are instructed for a reason. But anyways, back to the subject with my cleanser. I just use it all over my face, make sure I get every little corner, because obviously in this area, down our skin, I bring my foundation all the way to my, like, my neck, just because in case I'm a little off and it doesn't match, I want to make sure I get it to look even. So I basically used to spin brush all this on my hairlines, down my neck, by my ears, every bit I can, except for like the under eye area or anything like that, just because it can be harsh on me, causing wrinkles to happen. But this is what I use to cleanse anything, any makeup that's left over from removing it with the makeup wipes and whatnot. So once I do that, after I use this acne cleanser, I love to go in with my Murex skin polish. So if you're familiar with waxing on cars, you know that when you do a wax on it, it's basically polishing your car to look, you know, more brighter, more shinier. Just take those little, you know, dead scratch things away. Just make it look basically polished. And that's what I compared this Mira Skin Smoothing Polish to. It says it's deeply exfoliates to leave skin soft and smooth, which is so awesome. My mom, everyone that I recommend this loves it. Even my best friend is using it now, and she loves how it's leaving her skin. And I know if she watches this video, you're gonna text me and be like, yo, that is right. I love this thing so much because it's an exfoliator. It has like little micro beads in it that basically helps relieve congested pores. And it is true, because ever since I incorporated this in my skincare routine, right after I, so the thing was, when I started using this, I moved more into like, you know, scavenger hunt into the Murex collection to see what was gonna work for my skin. So I was getting samples here and there. When I did receive the sample of this one, I fell in love. Immediately, the same day that I used it, my skin was, it felt like baby skin, like a baby's butt, literally. Like, it just felt so smooth. And this does cause a difference the next day when I go to apply my makeup. Just because I do have textures, since I do have pores and I have like little blackheads under my skin, when I don't use this for 2 or 3 days, I can tell the difference. I can tell the texture in my skin. This definitely does make a big difference. Besides cleansing, it also tones your skin, which is another important factor in your skincare routine. So I use the Murex Acne Cleanser. Once that helps me remove every makeup that's left over, I'm going with this one. And I just use like, I just like literally on my finger apply like a little pea, like a little tiny, a small amount. You don't need more. Make sure your face is damp, not too super wet, just damp enough, and just go ahead and start scrubbing where you think your congested pores are at for like a good 3 to 5 minutes. I have a text message. Anyways, yeah, start scrubbing all over those congested areas, your forehead as well too. Basically, all over your face, like I said, 3 to 5 minutes. Go ahead and rinse it, and once you pat dry your face, you are going to notice the difference of how smooth your skin looks. Trust me when I tell you this. This is some good stuff. So then, what I go after with is with my Murad Rapid Age Spot Pigment Lightening Serum. I am a brown biscuit, of course. Brown biscuits, if you get acne and you pinch that acne, you're gonna get a dark spot. And that shit is hard to remove. It's complicated. When I used to pick my acne, I used to get blackheads. Like, not blackheads, but I used to get a dark spot. And it was so frustrating because when you try to apply concealer, you try to apply foundation, it's just extra building, and you can still see the discoloration in your skin. So either way, that was another factor in like my whole acne serious thing going on that was just, you know, ruining my life. Like, I feel like I was just depressed because of it. I feel like everyone would notice my skin. It was just me feeling that way personally. And this stuff is expensive, but this changed my life completely. My mom, she suffered from sunspot damage like for so many years and tried to get rid of it with so many products. I'm telling you, my mom spent thousands of dollars wanting to get rid of the spots. When she started using this, because she was the first one before me, honestly, her sunspots were gone in 2 weeks. These sunspots that she's been trying to get rid of for years were gone in just 2 weeks. So just imagine how, if those sunspots were on her face for years and mine were only for a few months there, how of a difference it made. As soon as I started using this as well, I noticed a big change. Like, I started seeing that my dark spots started going away. And even then, just basically with texture, I suffer from texture as well on my skin, which is the thing besides my pores. It's texture, and you know, there's primers that I have to use to make my skin look really smooth. There's sometimes where it's hard to get it to that way. But I'm telling you, this thing here not only helps your dark spots, it also helps with texture, just smoothing out your skin. You have to be careful when applying this and going out to the sun because it can be very damaging. This just serum is so strong that you definitely have to apply sunscreen. So if you're going to be using anything like this, anything that's this related to this serum, please use sunscreen. It can cause it to damage your skin even more. But like I said, this serum has completely changed my life. This is one thing that I probably won't give up because, of course, if I pick out a pimple or a whatever sip, the dark spot is going to be there and I need it to be removed within a few days. And this does its duty. So definitely you should look into seeing this because this does treat and repair your skin. This is some good stuff as well. Just a mirror and skin line in general is really, really good. But besides that, I also, you know, apply face masks here and there. I'm not a huge fan of one specific face mask. I do maybe use 3 times a week, twice a week. It can be any type of face mask as long as it's something that I know that that's gonna be either smoothing, a moisturizing my skin, for my blackheads, for of course, just mask. They can be $1, $2, $3, $4, $5, $10, I don't care. Some type of mask where you're gonna basically be helping your skin throughout the night. So lately I've been using it's this Jeju Natural a little mask that I've been using from a local store. Basically, I have 3 here. This one is the Jeju Natural Aloe Mask. I can't say that word. But this one's for soothing and moisturizing. Every time, for example, I pick out my pimples or blackheads or anything like that, and I'm already cleansed, I go ahead and apply this one because I know it's going to soothe out my skin and moisturize it from all that picking that I did myself or anything like that. If my face is red, if my face is swollen, just in general, I like to use this one. I also use this canola honey mask. It's nutrition supplied and tightened skin. So when, you know, those days where you're just like, oh, bummed out, stressed out, kind of like tired, you know, just basically things like that where you feel like your skin needs that extra supplement, I like to go in with this honey one. It's nutrition basically for your skin. More on the pore side, they do have this volcanic mask that I apply. It's for pore care and sebum control. Basically, you can use masks for anything you like. It doesn't have to be for like a specific thing. I mean, if you want to, you can. But for me, I just use any facial mask that I like. I can do charcoal ones. I can do, you know, just like the little paper ones like this ones. Any type of mask that you think works for you, go ahead and try them. They're a good thing to add basically to your skincare. And I love these first thing. Not only this brand, but just in general, and kind of a little basket thing going. And then I'm also gonna go in and talk about this Murad Complete Reform with Glyco. It's also to repair and treat your skin, but I don't use this on a daily basis. Just like my face mask, I only apply it here and there. So for example, if I'm going to be using this today, then tomorrow I'm not going to use it. I'm gonna go in and go with this Murad Glyco Firming Complex thingy-majiggy. This is a serum as well, but this is way stronger than that one. This one is the shit. This one can literally just in the night, the next day will remove texture and the little bumps or anything that you have, you know, swollen open pores that you have, anything like that, within a night. I can tell the difference when I do use this. For example, if I were to just use my Murad one day and 2 days later or a day later I don't use it, my skin will react immediately to it. I don't know what it's about my skin, but I can tell right away a difference. But with this one, I'm telling you, if I don't use my serum, this one, I definitely go in with this one. Because usually I don't have dark spots every day. It's here and there, but I still use it on a daily basis. But when I see that I don't have any dark spots and I necessarily need to use it on an everyday basis, I go in with this Murad Complete Reform. This one also works. If you are just wanting to get rid of texture, make your skin feel smooth for next day application, this is what's going to help you. So you just massage it evenly to the areas that you want to do it. It's going to burn a little bit, tingle in certain areas. I mean, that's on my case, but I'm telling you, this is strong, but it's a good type of strong. It's like, it will repair your skin. All right, so the Murad Treat Repair Age Reform. It's pricing, what your skin's worth. Like I said, it's an organ that you want to take care of, so do the most you can. So not only do I go ahead and use those products, but then again, the next day when I want to moisturize my skin, of course I go in with my Murad Hydrodynamic Ultimate Moisturizer. Oh my god, this is like a luxurious moisturizer, honestly. Like, it's like if you, I use moisturizer to the point where I applied them and then I felt my face so greasy where I can't stand it, where I have to remove it just because then my T-zone is super oily. But this thing, it's like it moisturizes your skin with a luxurious velvety texture to the moisturizer. But it's like if your skin swallows it, like it penetrates it immediately. So not only, you know, on the surface of it, but in, you know, underneath your skin, you start feeling like, man, my skin feels really hydrated. It's like you were super thirsty, you drink water, you're like, oh man, I feel good. It's the same thing with this moisturizer. I'm not telling you to use this moisturizer. There's so many moisturizers out there, really affordable ones that work awesome. But for me, this one works just because my T-zone is super oily. And every moisturizer I use, honestly, would always make me generate that extra oil, which I don't know why. But this one here doesn't create that. This one is another. Like, every time I apply it, like, I'll get oily. Of course, everyone gets oily. It's something you're not going to be able to control. But it doesn't cause me to be as extra oily as other moisturizers that I've used. This one kind of, like, balances it out. You know, and then my dry areas, of course, it hydrates the shit out of it. Like, just makes my skin feel good. I love this stuff. And like I said, go ahead and get yourself a sample at Sephora of any of these products. I mean, give it a try. Don't go ahead and buy a full $50 product and then end up hating it. Like I said, try samples. Your skin might react in a good way or in a bad way. Like, you know, what works for you might not work for me. What works for me might not work for you. It's kind of like a, you know, you have to try it first. So get samples if you not wanted to pay high prices for it. But anyways, I also, before I finish talking more of my, you know, everyday skincare routine, this company was nice enough to contact me and send me, you know, some products, and I've been using them for a week now. And like, I like charcoal clay mask, but I'm not like a huge fan of them. But I've incorporated this skincare line into my routine, and they sent me a charcoal clay mask, a bunch of things. So I've been using it for a week now, and there's like specific instructions to how to use it for your acne. Of course, the owner of this company was also, you know, suffering of acne, and she basically wanted to find a way to help others with the battle of acne. So I broke it. Seriously, the first day I opened the packaging, I broke it. It wouldn't be me if I wouldn't drop something and break it. But this charcoal clay mask has done a difference to my skin. Like, as soon as I take it off, the next day my skin is like really smooth. And I'm talking about all these products because I switch it up on a daily basis. Like, of course, I have my products that I use every single day. But at, like, serums and oils and things that I switch it up. I don't use the same serums. Like, for example, these two, I might use them twice a week, three times a week. But the other 2-3 days, of course, I go ahead and use other products. I don't use, like, everything on a daily basis because I like to give my skin a little bit of everything. Of course, you want to give your body different nutrition on every daily basis. The same thing with your skincare. So I've used this already about 4 times, and those 4 times that I've used this charcoal clay mask, I can tell you that the next day my skin feels nice. Like, it feels rejuvenated. Like, I don't know how to say it, but I can tell the difference. Like, my skin just feels healthy. Like, of course, it's really uncomfortable to wear just because it starts drying out and it's hard for you to, like, you know, things like that, because of course it's a clay mask that dries up and it does tighten your skin. But of course, it's going to, pull out all that bacteria, all that nasty stuff out of your skin to the surface, which is always a good thing because we have a lot of things underneath our skin that we're not aware of. And by using any charcoal clay mask, I'm telling you, you're going to see a difference within, I don't know how long, depending on the product you're using. But for me, this Spanish charcoal clay mask has been doing a difference, and I'm going to continue on using it. So if you would like to see more reviews on it further in depth about this brand, of course, I'm going to leave my Snapchat below in the description box, and you can always follow me there. They also did go ahead and send me the Vitamin C Beauty Elixir, which is a facial spray, and I applied it before anything. Basically, after I'm done with my skincare, like my washes, whatever, removal of makeup, I go ahead and spray this. The 4-10 that I used the clay mask, I've sprayed this before. I've sprayed some onto the powder and then added water, then applied it. And this, it's a vitamin C. I really can't say much about it because I haven't noticed a huge difference. I've only been using it for 4 days. But of course, since it was sent to me, I do want to give it a try. I will have, you know, later on, of course, what it's doing to my skin, what it's not, honest reviews of how I like this product. But until now, I cannot say much of it, but I've incorporated this into my skincare routine. And lately, I've been more onto like the dewy skin, like the facial oils into my foundations or just oils on my skin rather than primers. Facial oils have honestly replaced my Murad Invisible Perfecting Shield. So this was my shit. It still is because it basically blurs out any imperfections you have. There's those days where I don't want to wear makeup and I'm going to go ahead and run errands on my days off or things like that, or the weekends, or I just need to go grab something really quick. I go ahead and just apply some of this Invisiblur. It does have SPF 30, and that's what I like because obviously I don't have to apply moisturizer and an SPF. This does everything, and besides that, it also works as a primer for your foundation. So if you don't want to use it to just, you know, on the days that you're not wearing makeup or anything like that, you can definitely use it as a primer, but it's a little expensive for a primer, so you might not want to spend $65, I believe that's the price for it, for this as a primer. Unless you have the money for it, go for it. Or you don't wear foundation every day, go for it. But of course, on the days that I don't wear foundation or I do, this is the shit. But ever since I started getting more into facial oils, I've kind of made that to the side. And lately, I've been using this Boots number 7 Youthful Replenishing Facial Oil. Oh my god. This, I love this stuff. This stuff makes my foundation go on so smooth. With makeup or without makeup, my skin feels youthful. Like honestly, like when I read this, I was like, okay, let's see what it's about. Let's see if it really does what it's saying. And the same day I bought it, I applied it in the car because I was wearing no foundation, nothing. So I applied it to my skin because I was like, I can't wait, you know? So this is esperado like that. So I applied it, and a few minutes later, I was like, my skin feels good. Like this stuff makes my skin look good. It feels good. You know, I kept raving about it to my boyfriend in the car, like, I like this stuff. You know, and I was just like, I'm going to give it a try the next day with my foundation. So I applied it on, placed my primer. Seriously, my primer went so smooth. My skin just felt so nice. Like, it's never felt hydrated smooth at the same time. It was just like a combination of, I don't know, like, it was just like a really good feeling. Like, I don't know, I just like to feel things on my skin and how they feel. If it feels weird, I just take it off immediately. But then I applied like a few drops, like 2 drops on my foundation. Some of my beauty blender started applying, and I felt like my foundation, even if it's my full coverage, it didn't take the full coverage away, but it made it dewy. But hold on though, it didn't make it dewy to where it made it super oily, where you're just irritated of being oily and you have to blot your face with freaking translucent powder. So unfortunately, the camera had died. So it cut me off in the part, I guess, where I was talking about facial oils. Anyways, I've been into facial oils.
Cut it off. It looks too close.
Yeah, it will try a little further. It's not as like how it was before. Cut it off.
Okay then.
Is it still filming though?
Yeah. I'm gonna take one to start again.
You guys don't talk, shut up.
There, shut up. I mean, there goes start. It's the same video, so you have to cut it.
So my camera had died, unfortunately, cut me off at a certain area where I was talking about facial oils and how I've been loving this Boots number 7 Youthful Replenishing Oil. And I've been using it every day, and I've been loving it so much. This is my second bottle, right? If you can just imagine, because, of course, I use up things when I like them so much a lot. But anyways, like I said, this skincare line, Banish, has sent me all these products to try out. And of course, I'm trying them out because I want to give them a try. you know, they're for acne and things like that. And obviously I suffered from acne, and I wished a company would have reached out to me then and tried out their products and helped me out rather than me, you know, how do you say, looking into wanting to go to a dermatologist, which either way I found out my skincare and what I was doing. So, of course, in the package, there was this oil, this facial oil included as well. And the instructions do say that you can apply it either when you're using the Vanisher, which is a dermal roller, or just basically on an everyday basis if you like. And I use it on a daily basis. I've been replacing it, you know, replacing this one a little bit just because I want to give this one a try. So I've kind of been like, you know, pushing it aside to give it a try. Of course, it doesn't do the same thing as this one does when I do add a few drops into my foundation. This one's like more of a thicker version, so it just keeps my skin very moisturized and oily, which at times it can kind of be a little irritating just because my hair will get stuck, have it down or whatnot, or like little, you know, fizzle things, you know, all of a sudden are flying in the air, you'll see one stuck. And because it's thicker, I'd rather just not use it in my foundation. But definitely, and that whole product and all the products they sent me, they went ahead and said this dermal rollers. So the dermal rollers will basically, there's a way of using it. In this one, you can only use it up to 4 times, I believe. You have to dip it in alcohol before you use it and after you use it. It does have little needles here, which I don't want to run my fingers through because it's clean. And it's basically puncturing your skin. It is painful if you use it with, if you're heavy-handed. That is why you have to roll it just specific, or it's 4 to 5 times. You can't go back and forth, because of course the way you're going to roll it is going to be puncturing your skin. And when it does that, when I'm done just puncturing the areas that I want to, which is my more complicated areas, the area that I wish I didn't have complications, which is my pores. Those little craters there are so irritating because that's the reason my skin or foundation doesn't look good. The reason why that happened is because I had blackheads and I was extracting them, or they would just come out of there and we'll leave those little craters there. But these dermal rollers are supposed to help basically restructure your skin. So they're gonna go ahead and puncture it, and once that happens, your skin is going to react as the way as if your skin was damaged, and it's going to basically regenerate new skin. So that's what I'm wanting it to do, and I'm focusing only that area that I have the pores at. Nothing else but the pore areas. And once I finish doing that, I do apply this Vanish oil. Oh my god. So the first time I did it, I was like in tingling pain. Like I was literally in tingling pain. And it was just so frustrating because I'm like, oh my god, my face is burning. But the reason that's happening is because this oil, the punctures you made, the oil was going deep into the little punctures, and it's basically, you know, giving it nutrition and just giving it that supplement that it needs. You get me? Like it all comes together. Like, it's hard for me to explain it just because I'm picturing it in my head the way I'm doing it. And I've tried this dermal roller already twice, and I tell you, from the first time it burned, but then again, it's for a good cause. It's not like you're just ruining your skin. It's doing something, obviously. It's in the skincare because it's supposed to help you. And if it's gonna help, you know, my pores or anything like that, just rebuild new skin, I'll take the pain. What can I tell you? I'll take the pain. But definitely, of course, you do wanna keep in mind that you do use makeup brushes on a daily basis. If you use beauty blenders, anything that you apply on your face brushes, you have to maintain clean. I've gotten into the habit of washing them as often as I can before I would be a month or something, which I think about it as it grows. So I'm trying to get into the habit of just cleaning them so often. With my beauty blenders, that's what I use for my foundation, I clean them every day that I'm going to use them. Every day I clean them just because I don't want the bacteria that's built up from the previous foundation use that I applied on it to go back onto my skin. That just be very disgusting. You do want to give deep cleansing to beauty blenders because, of course, the foundation, it does suck up the foundation very deep when you just don't wash it every day. And that also can help hurt your skin really bad. So just make sure that the tools that you're using, that if you're applying makeup or not, that you're cleaning it. Also, another thing that I started using, this is no products, nothing, your pillowcases. Your pillowcases and the towels that you're using to dry your face need to be clean as well. If you're sleeping on a pillowcase that basically your hair goes on, your hair if you're gonna have your hair curled or done, it's gonna have, of course, you're gonna use serums, oils, hairspray, whatever. You're out on the day, the night, whatever, a bunch of dust things get attracted to it. And if you don't wash your hair every day, of course, and you sleep on the pillowcase, just keep in mind that you're applying your face to it after you just cleanse your face. And all that bacteria from your hair or just anything, the dirtiness from the previous days, it's gonna go back on your skin. And then it'd be no point if you wanting to have all the skincare routine when your pillowcase is dirty. So just keep in mind, if your pillowcase is dirty, apply a clean shirt. The next day, another clean shirt. You're not dirtying them, you're just preventing from any bacteria. But try to wash them as often as you can. If for instance, you forget a night, apply a clean shirt. Because that's what I do. I'm not gonna say I'm perfect and I wash my pillowcase every day. But I do switch up the shirts that I use on them, and I just sleep on them, and I tie my hair up sometimes, or I just kind of try to avoid of getting in my face. Besides doing that, make sure that the towels you're using to clean your face are not the same ones you're drying your body. Don't be the nasty person who dries their butt crack, other BJJ, and then after you use the same towel to go ahead and clean your face. Very disgusting. Very, very disgusting. Don't do that. Make sure you have a clean towel, separate from your body and separate from your face. If you don't have a towel, go ahead and purchase some. They're super cheap, or just use paper towels. Believe me when I say, you gotta maintain all these things to be clean. What I do when I don't wash, of course, all of my eye brushes or face brushes, I do have this here. It's just like a dollar bottle with alcohol in it. Before I use anything, I spray it. Because, of course, alcohol dries up super quick and it kills bacteria, so it kills two birds with one stone. So before I use anything, I squirt alcohol all over it, let it dry for a few seconds, and then I use it. Because of course, any bacteria going on your skin, and with you having a problematic acne skin, it's gonna be really bad. So just keep in mind that you wanna make, you know, incorporate either new skincare, just the habits of your life. You can have the most expensive things to use on your face, but if, like I say, you're sleeping on dirty pillowcases, you're using the same dirty brushes or whatnot, there's basically no reason for you to be using this. You need to incorporate a difference in things you're doing. For me, all this has helped me get rid of acne, is helping me. So like I said, what might work for me might not work for you. What works for you might not work for me. I recommended the Murex. For some people, it didn't work. For some, awesome. They loved it. But I'm just giving you some of my tips and tricks, some things I do on my night routine or whatnot, just my skincare, because I do more than the day. The day I just use like an everyday cleanser, which I forgot to bring here because I'm recording downstairs. But anyways, like I said, I will leave all the products I use below in the description box. I will leave my Facebook, my Snapchat, my Instagram, just basically any other social media for you guys to keep up with me. On my Snapchat is where I engage with more with little mini makeup tutorials and reviews on makeup rather than YouTube. I am trying to come back as often as I can. I'm just working really hard on all of this. Anyways, if you guys did like this skincare routine, of course, first video of 2017, give it a thumbs up, like, share, and subscribe. Of course, I'm going to incorporate skincares, hair tutorials, makeup tutorials, just a little bit of everything. And of course, stay tuned for a vlog that's gonna be coming up. So anyways, thank you guys so much. See you next time.